And we want to experiment quite heavily with flipped learning, and for that reason, we have established an Institute for Higher Education Research and Innovation. This is called iHeard. Our director was hired back from the US. He was here in the morning, and he was the leading expert in intelligent tutoring systems. So coupled with AIs, we'll be able to do a lot of personalized AI tutoring for flipped learning.
在看片之前，大家记得分享、赞好和订阅卓见名家，最紧要揿埋呢个钟仔，咁你就唔会错过我哋嘅最新影片。
The topic I actually made up the topic in Chinese first, and then I realized I had to provide a topic in English, which is a little bit of Chinglish, I think. Okay, so. Now, before my talk, three presidents have talked on the issue of AI in education. So this was Professor Tang from NUS, and then we had Professor Gong Qihuang from Beijing University, Professor Zhou Qing of Lingnan University. They have all talked about it. I was doing this my slides last night, so I was expecting they would have talked about all these nice things. So I'm going to be very specific as an engineer on what we think we should be doing at PolyU. But I have to show you this because we want to differentiate ourselves to be a university which is very keen on making more direct contributions to the society, because PolyU's history dated from the thing called the government trade school in Hong Kong. It was set up to support the industry of Hong Kong. So we still have that genetic feature in our disciplines particularly. So if I show you my discipline, you will see that we have strong presence in engineering in two faculties. We have construction environment, which is for the construction industry. Then we have engineering, which is for the manufacturing industry. In Hong Kong, even until today, the highest school, entry score for engineering programs at the PolyU, apart from biomedical engineering, is still civil engineering and a surveying kind of programs. Maybe as time goes on, as we have more manufacturing, this situation will change. We also have unique disciplines, things like design, fashion, textiles, hotel and tourism management. Under health sciences, we have physiotherapy, occupational therapy, optometry, medical laboratory sciences. All these are what we call unique disciplines among the eight public universities, because when we were asked to do this, the newer universities were not there yet. So this gives us some very unique features. And therefore, this is our positioning of the university. We want to be an innovative university in the sense that I will explain later. Of course, everybody wants to be innovative. So how innovative you are, it depends on how you position yourself. Because of our tradition in engineering and technology, we want to have a strong presence in engineering and technology area disciplines. Of course, we have many of our sister institutions very keen on engineering and technology also. We want to be world leading in the unique disciplines, and I think we are already there in many of these disciplines. So by innovation, we want our graduates to be leaders of innovation. But this is maybe also the case with some other universities. We want our research to benefit society more directly. This is our mission. So we often jokingly say that if you want to study the origin of the universe or the meaning of life, you know, you have to go to Hong Kong U to study. And one time I was speaking to Rocky, he said you can also go to Chinese U because they have a department of philosophy or the department of theology. We don't have things like that. So we want our innovation spirit to be embedded in all aspects of our work. Now let's talk about things to do with AI. So what does AI mean to us? And all the things have been talked about. So I don't really go through this. We all know that if AI comes, certain jobs will disappear. Some new jobs will appear. But there's nothing to panic, because this has happened many times in the history. When the steam engines were invented, you know, labor, hard labor was replaced, When we had computers, like in my profession, we used to have a lot of people doing drawings, you know. Nobody is doing it now because it's all done by computers. So when you have a new technology, of course, things will change. But of course, that means that we have to retrain our students in a way which will, you know, suit the future needs of the society. They don't have to remember so many things. Somebody will say that because of this AI, because the Chinese, you know, tradition of education is spoon feeding a lot. This includes university in Hong Kong to some extent. But this tradition, maybe it's a good opportunity for us now, because now we can see the spoon feeding process is maybe very obviously not useful. So I guess we hope this is an opportunity for us. Now we can talk about lots of attributes that students should have now in the AI age. But in my own view, the most important ability is always the self-learning ability and the desire to learn as a lifelong learner. In fact, in my university, I don't know about yours, maybe the same, you know, we have a lot of exam papers in the library. But this is maybe not a good thing because students go to the library to do the example problems that were set last time. So self-learning, I think, is the main thing. In my view, if you graduate from a university with a bachelor degree, you should possess the ability to self-learn. If you are able to do that, then you are a properly, you know, qualified graduate. The other stuff, I think, I'll not talk about. So in terms of the pedagogy, I think basically, a few years ago, 2 years ago, we were discussing in Hong Kong, you know, newspapers say things like, can you allow people to use AI in your study or in assignment? You know, we at PolyU, we from the very beginning, you know, of course, UST was the first to be very progressive. We have been since then after UST, we have always said we embrace AI. There's nothing to prevent. There's no reason to prevent us from allowing students using AI, because AI is going to be used in workplaces. They must use it also in their studies. And then I think, you know, people have talked about flipped learning. Before the pandemic, flipped learning was experimented, but it was never easy. After the pandemic, online learning has become so much more accepted. AI-based, you know, personalized tutoring system is now much more powerful. I think this flipped learning is really a thing we must, you know, do a lot more in the future. And also reality, you know, we don't need to get students to read so much books maybe now, but if they can have more exposure to reality and sometimes to virtual reality, we have this kind of capability, you know, to allow them to do it. So in terms of the educational offerings, we should make AI mandatory study subject for, you know, students from primary school to university. We have, of course, to sunset programs and offer new programs. In fact, for example, at PolyU, we were the first to offer a Master of Science in Blockchain Technology in Asia, the first to offer a Master of Science in Metaverse Technology in the whole world. You can try to innovate with your programs. Now, AI, you know, everybody should learn some AI. So actually before ChatGPT became popular, in 2020, we already at the PolyU made the decision that Professor Alex Wai was part of the team. We made the decision that we will make AI compulsory. And this was done from the 2022 cohort before ChatGPT became popular. So since then, we already have a compulsory subject for AI. This is, based on my understanding, the world's first university to have done this. UST has a good idea of this X Plus, and we had something similar, but more extensive. So this is called X Plus ADA. We made AI a secondary major, which is 36 credits. 36 credits is bigger than a master program in Hong Kong. So 26 of our programs, students are allowed to take AI as their secondary major, 36 credits. By doing this, we are turning out a lot of people who are knowledgeable in their first major, like design, language studies, engineering, together with a secondary major in AI. Because in the future, a lot of people will use AI more or less as a black box, like what we do with software. But they have to have a bit of understanding of AI, so they know how to gather, process, analyze data before AI can be used properly. So to me, this is a good way going forward for AI. We have a similar system with innovation and entrepreneurship. We are going to, because of the, you know, we are in a lack of space, we don't have space, so the area that we can move forward much more easily is AI instead of biology. So we are setting up a new faculty. We will do it maybe in July and moving our applied mathematics, computer science into a new faculty. This will be the faculty of, the name is being debated because the two departments have to argue how they are going to name the faculty, but we are going to have a new faculty. Eventually, we may have four or five departments. So this will be the growth area of PolyU in the next three or five years. And we want to experiment quite heavily with flipped learning, and for that reason, we have established an Institute for Higher Education, Research and Innovation. This is called iHeard. Our director was hired back from the US. He was here in the morning, and he was the leading expert in intelligent tutoring systems. So coupled with AIs, we'll be able to do a lot of personalized AI tutoring for flipped learning. Finally, I want to say just a few words on this thing called Hong Kong as an international education hub. Because of the time, I only want to highlight one thing. I think for Hong Kong to attract more students from Belt and Road countries or foreign countries, the key is financial support. Because developed countries, they have an affordable system of higher education. It's unlikely for them to come to Hong Kong and pay a high tuition fee. Developing countries, students don't have money. So the solution is to build a loan system where the students from a developing country can take out a loan, study in Hong Kong, find a job, and repay the loan. Hong Kong nowadays have a lot of jobs, If they come here to do a master degree program, the cost is only 300,000. They can pay off in a few years' time. So I've proposed this to the government, and we have discussed it among the university presidents, and I want to share this suggestion with you. So if you find it feasible, you can also air your support when you have the chances. Thank you so much.
鍾義名家分析，記得俾 like 同埋分享，支持同訂閱卓見名家，最緊要撳埋呢個鐘仔，咁就唔會錯過我哋嘅新片。